Welcome back. We have trash talking Melinda Caldwell. I'm sorry, I just had to say
that. Now, Melinda, you've been here before.
I have.
I think one time before, and we talked trash then.
Yes.
But now, if you're a Harrison resident, you're going through a lot of changes.
Yes.
And a lot of frustration.
Yes.
So are you here to answer all of those problems? Or
I would love that we could do that. But I'm here to help shine some light, because I think it's been kind of confusing. People mm-hmm. have two containers that show up. One mm-hmm. of them is way bigger than the trash.
Right.
The recycling container is bigger than the trash container. And what to do? Because a lot of people haven't really explored the amount of recycling that we can actually do in Harrison now.
And that's the key word is recycle, because a lot of people don't.
Yeah.
And that's going to be the hard transition for them.
Yes, it is.
But at some point in everyone's life, I mean, as we live on this earth, we're going to have to start doing that on a regular basis, right?
Yes, one of the things we talked about the last time, and one of the things I do with the Solid Waste District is deal with the cost of trash as it's buried in a landfill, and mm-hmm. it has long-term costs. And so mm-hmm. it's actually better on a short-term cost standpoint to throw our stuff that's reusable in the recycle bin.
Okay.
And Harrison is so progressive because we have an incredible service that can take almost everything you use in your household mm-hmm. in the recycle container.
Henceforth, that's why you have a bigger recycle thing than
yes.
you do a trash
that's
can.
That's true, because
I mean,
really about 60 to 70% of what we generate in our house as refuse is a recyclable item. And that's why the recycle container is larger than the trash container.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, you brought some photos of what to do and what not to do.
Yes.
As far as trash goes. Let's look at those first of what, I don't know which one you're going to throw up first. Oh. That's what you're
That, you know, I love that picture, because there's the container that was supplied and then their own personal container. And then if you look in the back, the recycled container is back there empty.
Uh-huh.
Now,
uh-huh.
I just kind of glanced at that trash, but I can see there is a lot of recyclable items in there. And so if they would pull that recycled container out and throw loosely, a lot of what you see in those bags probably would be in that blue container with the yellow lid.
Wow.
So you saw that black container there. Is that a no-no?
Yes.
Okay.
You know, currently they are short on containers, so there's probably about 50 residents who don't have their containers yet.
Mm-hmm.
They can use their own personal ones. But those of us who have our containers need to use the containers supplied, because the truck that's picking them up has an automated arm, and it's picking it up with an automated arm.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, that's not going to – being able to use your own container is going to mm-hmm. have to –
Now, do you bag it?
Trash, you want to bag. The recycling, they're sorting, so you don't want to
okay.
bag your recycling.
Okay.
Your recycling, you just want to throw in loose.
Well, let's go ahead.
Well, I was going to ask, too, you know, like, I'm thinking around Christmas time, we always have loads of trash, extra trash. So, I mean, like, paper can be recycled, but what do you do if you have more than it's going to fit in that container?
Well, I think that's a lot of is experimenting, because I myself am finding myself having to go back to the trash can and pull stuff out that I couldn't recycle before.
Mm-hmm.
And I think what people will see is they get better at what they can recycle. They'll see that that's not an issue.
Okay.
So that's really, truly about 60 to 70% of what is in their trash can go in the recycle bin.
Okay.
And when you talk about recycling, you have some examples here of cans, and we'll talk about a milk jug and just
mm-hmm.
as an example, and also boxes that take up a lot of space. When you try to put it in that large blue one,
mm-hmm.
it's going to fill up very quickly. So can you smash these items?
Yeah. The best thing to do is to break down your recycle bin. I mean, your container. Like for example, this toothpaste container, which isn't a big example, but just open it up and flatten it out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And what I do, because I'm not going to have my big container right by my house, I still do my same thing. I have a paper bag that I get from our grocery store,
mm-hmm.
and I just set that in my house, and I throw my stuff in there.
Mm-hmm.
It used to just be all paper that I threw in there, but
what else can you put in there now?
Well, I mean, I put everything in there just to make my life easier, and then I just walk this bag to my container, and I dump it out in my blue container with the lid. So, for example, today I had to go fish this out of the trash, my Harrison Daily Times bag, because
okay.
I used to throw this in the trash,
mm-hmm.
but now I can throw it in my recycle bin.
Okay.
And for example, this, I save this because it's a great example. This can, after I use it, I'll rinse it out, and I will put it in the recycle bin.
Will you take the label off?
No, you don't have to take the label off.
Okay.
Okay.
Super easy. And then this paper, this plastic that was wrapped in, that goes in the recycle bin
okay.
too. So there's really no waste
exactly.
in that whole product.
Exactly.
Well, we were talking earlier. I recycle at home, been doing it for years. What do you do with light bulbs? Because that goes in a special place other than trash and batteries.
Right.
That
if
kind of
you
thing.
Some batteries are considered safe for the landfill. We have drop-off spots for mercury-filled light bulbs at our hazardous waste trailer, and that would be the best place for you to put the spiral light bulbs. Actually, have mercury in them.
Oh, so, really?
Yeah. So do they need to be put separate?
Yes, they don't need to go in our recycle containers.
Or,
they need
or trash.
To go to the hazardous waste trailer, and that's currently parked at the methane.
But I'm sure they will be mixed in.
Well, I hope not.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what, you know, I always tell people, try to imagine you're the one that's separating this material at the processing facility. Just imagine you doing that.
Mm-hmm.
You would want those containers rinsed, especially a milk jug in July, you can imagine.
Mm-hmm.
So just try to be thoughtful of the people who are separating it and put the right stuff in the right spot.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you really will have room in the containers that have been supplied if you just put it in the right spot. I brought this too. This was super cool. I had to dig this out of the trash because, I mean, truthfully, we couldn't recycle that 3 months ago in Harrison, and now we can.
Okay, good.
And if you have, well, let's say where you tell me you could take the stuff if, say, you live in the county and you're not in the city, then you can still utilize
a drop-off. Right. All of these recycling options are available to you, which is a much expanded program. It's 1 through 7 plastic. So when you look at the bottom of your recycle thing, it should be a 1 through 7. This isn't going to have a recycle symbol on it, but just know your packaging can go. And there is a drop-off facility at the old UNFI location. You go to the very top of the hill on Cottonwood and take your entrance to the right, and there's a drop-off facility there for county folks that want to take their material in.
Okay.
Awesome.
Good. What about newspaper and Slick magazine,
three-color? You know, it's all just the classic stuff. Newspapers, we've always been able to recycle. Just throw that stuff in. Your junk mail. We all have a ton of junk mail, which we don't necessarily want, but you can throw that in your recycle bin. The good thing about your recycle bin is you really want to keep the lid closed because that paper needs to stay dry. So when you do rinse out your containers, just throw them in the strainer, let them kind of dry out a little bit, and then put them in the recycle bin.
Okay.
So you do want the lids to close on your containers.
Okay, I was going to ask you that.
Yeah. Yeah, because that's part of it. There are some people who are like, by God, I'm not going to recycle. And I think that, you know, that'll just take some time to realize it's not that bad.
Yeah.
It'll be all right.
And I'm sure people that don't have garbage disposal are going to throw their food waste, too, in the trash, which is acceptable, I would assume.
It is. I mean, for me, I'm a gardener. I have a compost pile.
Yeah.
And I don't really throw any food waste in the trash unless it's something that I know my dog, like a piece of bread, which I know my dog should not be eating. I don't.
Mm-hmm.
I keep my compost sequestered so that animals can't get into it.
Yeah.
But yes, you can put food waste in your trash if you
Well, if you do recycle, it's amazing how little you have left over.
So little.
Yeah.
That's why I don't know if you have a picture of actually my recycle can, and you can see how full my recycle can is and how empty my trash can is because there was such a small amount of trash for me.
Is that same Pizza Hut?
That is not. But that is such a great point. I'm so glad you brought that up. But that is a low volume trash, and there is a bag of trash in there. And I actually had a New Year's Day party, and that's party trash.
Wow.
Okay.
So that's pretty good. But the literature that went out said that pizza boxes were not recyclable, and that is not true.
Really?
A lot of us have pizza boxes. Just make sure that there's no food waste in the box and throw it in your recycle bin.
Okay.
We want the pizza boxes because that's a lot of cardboard.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It takes a little effort.
It takes a little effort, but, you know, people are throwing stuff in their trash can anyway. I imagine. So now it's just about making it easy in your household, and that's why I think using a paper bag or get a little tote or something that's easy for you to use and just bring it to your big container in lots and pieces. And you'll find that, you know, this is kind of fun.
Mm-hmm.
This is kind of a fun experiment because look at my recycle container.
Right.
Yeah.
It's filling
good.
Up.
This is great information. If someone has a question, can they call you directly?
They absolutely can call me. I'm not affiliated with Inland Trash Service. The city of Harrison is in our solid waste district, and part of my role is to help people understand the best solid waste practices they can. So I am available for any questions.
You're not employed by the city?
I am not employed by the city.
Okay.
I just happen to live here, and I want to see this program be successful.
And what areas do you cover?
We have a 6-county district. That's Searcy, Boone, Newton, Marion, Carroll, and Boone counties.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
So if anybody's interested in maybe starting recycling, which would be the best thing for you, you can call Melinda at the phone number that's on the screen. Yes, appreciate you being here.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me. Thanks for bringing all your stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to go take it and put it in my recycle bin now.
Okay, you can take that with you.
Yes, I will. I will take that with me. I bet you have a container here.
I don't.
Well, you will.
I don't. We recycle at home, but I'm getting... Of course, they're charging us for the pickup here anyway, so we're getting those.
Yeah, because they are going to be offering commercial recycling carts. So you guys are a commercial business. Yeah. You can get
We won't use it here, though. It'll take 2 or 3 weeks to fill it.
Well, yes, that's right. Yeah. You can save that and put that in there.
This paperwork?
That paperwork right there.
I was going to put it in your trash so you could take it with you.
Thanks so much
Thanks,
for having
Melinda.
Me.
Thanks, Melinda. Appreciate it. All right, up next, we're going to be talking with Ginger Oaks. Stay with us.